What is up, guys? It's your boy, Memes Are Here. And I will say something. I'm very surprised at the positive reaction. I see that a lot of you guys are interested in this series, and I'll keep continuing it. We're gonna go maybe 3 episodes per week. That way I don't get burned out, and that way you guys can, you know, get 3 new episodes on an FEBuilder tutorial series. And that's really nice to see all the comments y'all left in the comment section explaining how this is really helping you. That really keeps me motivated, so hope you guys keep watching, and hopefully you guys can make your own ROM hacks, you know. Maybe I can make a cameo and a wink wink. Anyways, I also like to announce that me and my friends that ROM hack that I've been hinting at, Grug's Primitive Disadventure, is going to be releasing tomorrow American time. So right now it's Friday for me as an American, so that means tomorrow, or Thursday for me as American, my bad. But tomorrow will be Friday, so I'll be releasing it tomorrow on Friday. And so you'll be looking, look forward to that. It's going to be on FEUniverse. We got 5 chapters playable. I got a lot of stuff done. We got a lot of bugs tested out. And I'm really proud of it. I'm surprised that it came out of the shit post. So I'm really surprised that it got out of the whole like demo phase. So check it out, guys. You know, any support really helps, you know. So thank you guys for supporting me. More than likely, just to be all wholesome. So we're going to be going over unit placement and battle animations today. So we're going to be going over the basics of unit placement and a little introduction to battle animations. So for example, we're going to go over how enemy AI works, how walking commands works, how death quotes, battle quotes can trigger events, how enemy units auto level, and even stuff like where to find custom animations if you do not know where they are. Because it's kind of hard. I mean, FEUniverse is kind of like, the format's kind of a bit difficult to traverse through your first time, especially when some threads have like over like 2,000 responses to them. Anyways, so I gave Kazuya, we're gonna go change his class first of all. This is where the battle animations come. So I changed his name, Blade, became a Blade Lord. His details is gonna be Master in the Way of the Sword. And I'm just gonna give him a 71, a C rank in swords. And maybe let's go add a little bit of HP. A lot of speed, because I know sword, Myrmidon's speed and skill are their thing. Maybe one less point of defense. A bit more con though, because he ain't no chick. So he's a bit more bulkier than Erica. And maybe just like 2 points of power, just so he's not totally useless. So what we're going to do, guys, is that we're going to go over to Animation Pointer. This is where you're going to find all the animations and how they're stored. And I'm going to teach you how to insert some custom animations. So this is how animations basically, this is the rundown of them. So each animation has the weapon types and an item slot. And so the game reads this. Like, let's say your unit is using the sword, it's going to load the sword animation. If it's using an item, it's going to load the item animation where they have nothing in their hands. And so, you know, classes that has multiple weapon types, like the general, have to have all this extra stuff. But we'll go into that more on my animation tutorial. But for now, let me show you just how to insert a basic animation. And it's all due to one button, and I'm so glad this is in there. It's import battle animation right here if you can't see it. So we're going to press import, and we're going to go over to my personal stash of battle animations right here. And let's see, what do we want today? He is a Myrmidon, so we might want to get a custom Myrmidon. Let's see. Oh, shoot. My bad. I forgot about music. I'll play this in the background so you don't have to hear my breathing and my ASMR voice. Right here. Awakening style. I was looking for this. Is this the female or the male version? It's the male version. So we're going to give him the awakening. The awakening style of Myrmidon. And as you can see, it's in the game now. It will now load as that when he goes on the field. And we'll also load an item, so that way it won't just revert back to Erica unarmed. Boom. We got it in, guys. Good job. I'll show you guys how to do palettes in a later episode, but right now this palette should do okay. But you may notice something. Erica's sprite, her map sprite, still the same. How do we change it? Press down on her sprite like I just did there. Press it on it. You'll be brought to the screen. It's going to say right here, display example, and you can switch through the frames to see if it works. This is for people who do spriting and sort. Again, import image, and you're going to have to find these assets on your own. They're all on FEUniverse in the what was it called? The grand repository of graphics and such. So we're gonna go to map sprites, gonna go to infantry, and we're gonna go look for our Fire Emblem Awakening sprite. Let's see. And they're really conveniently labeled. I really like that about the repository. Everything's labeled, has credits, so you can just go through. Make sure you credit the right people. Always credit your what assets you use, guys. Don't be an asshole and not do that. Trust me. I'm kind of lazy now, so we'll just choose a random one. Let's see. Let's do just this one right here. Short-haired. Okay, cool. It's in now. We also got to change the moving map animation if you're going to have them actually walk across the map. See? Press it right there. It says jump to moving map animation, and then boom. So again, import image. I don't really mess with AP. I don't know what that's all about. I don't know. I guess it's just something that more advanced users use. So let's see. Okay, you're going to see this too, guys. Hold on, let me turn on the music. So it's the one you got to pay attention. Anyways, so basically, you're going to start freaking out since pilot is different for specified. Don't freak out. Just press this middle one. Import by reconstruction with specified value. So don't freak out with that, okay, guys? Don't start, like, wondering, oh, no, is this not going to go in? So just press it. Should go in with no problem. I think it's just, like, a little bureaucratic stuff. And it's in now. Boom. It should update. And now he got a custom Myrmidon map sprite. Cool. So I basically just taught you how to insert your own custom animations. And axes are a different story, but we'll go over that in my in-depth animation tutorial that I'll probably make in the future. Anyways, so we're gonna go over now the unit placer. What's the unit placer? How does the unit placer work and all that such? And this is what we're gonna do, guys. We're gonna change Kaito's class in the unit placer. Now, even though his class and his character is Myrmidon, as you can see right here, it's not gonna load as Myrmidon because that's the support class. It shows you stats, that's taken in stat calculations. So, you're going to choose Myrmidon, and I already know the area it's located. Boom, Myrmidon. But if you don't know, you'll learn eventually, but if you don't know, just go into the class editor, load it up, double-click, boom, it's in there now. And we're going to give him like maybe like 5 levels for the heck of it. We're going to get rid of the Silver Lance by making it to 0, and we're going to move up this Vulnery right here. Boom, he's ready. And so that's how you change classes in your editor now. Look, here, updated in the right hand corner. And as you see, they're both Myrmidons now. Different Myrmidons, but Myrmidons nonetheless. Same thing goes for enemies. So let's make this guy, this fighter, into a soldier. But you also must change out the weapons too for that. Because if the weapons don't align, then they're just useless. They're just standing there, just free XP. So change a weapon, so we change to an Iron Lance. Hopefully all y'all saw that. Now let's talk about enemy AI and all these primary AI, secondary AI, target AI. Okay. These all are your AIs. A lot of them are pretty self-explanatory. Chance of action 100%, attack only when adjacent. But there's one thing that I actually myself did not know when I started this. How do you make those enemies where if you go in the range and they attack you? I thought it would be attack only when adjacent, but no, that just makes them just stay still. They don't move at all. What do you do? Well, what you do is you go to chance of action 100%, and you put do not move, and then once they enter their range, that's going to make them change. That's going to make them move and attack. So we did that. Boom. It's done. And so that's the enemy AI. There's some special one like do not attack Natasha, because Natasha doesn't get attacked by enemies on the map she joins. But, I mean, that's for you if you want to put that in the ROM hack. Do not attack certain citizens. Chance of an action, 100% attack. So, this is like, they will always attack. They won't use on vulneraries. They won't do anything. Summon, if they are summoner class. Or stealing. Yeah. And then, heal unit with HP. With HP is 50% or less. So, this is like for troubadours and the like. So right here, we got the different movement AI. So we got move towards enemy. Again, self-explanatory, they're going to move towards you. This one I don't really know, but I think it has to do with the Natasha and Citizens ones too. Do not move, which again means do not move. That's good for bosses. And this is for brigands. Attack village and treasure, then move towards enemy. Attack village and treasure, then move to escape point. So this is like for thieves when they go after your treasure chest inside castles. And then they can escape through a certain point. You can, I'll go over that later again, the event thing, but that's basically command for it. And brigands, when they attack a village, then they just go attack you afterwards. So that will be their main goal, is go for a village and attack it. There's some stuff involved with that, but it's pretty easy to get your head wrapped around it. If possible, detecting actions, move towards the enemy. Again, a lot of these are self-explanatory, so I'm not going to go through the whole list. But again, just, if you have any questions, I say just go on the Fire Emblem Universe Discord and ask about how the AI, what's some good AI stuff. Recovery mode, again self-explanatory. Recovery mode when HP 80% returned HP to 50%. So what it's basically saying is that if this unit has invulnerary, it's gonna try to find a way to heal itself once it goes underneath a certain threshold. And again, the thresholds vary. Like when recovery mode when HP is 10% and when try to return to 50%. And so that's, you can see that. Then there's priority. So again, it's like priority damage. This means accuracy. Priority regular damage or prioritize max damage. So this is for, you know, people who are really into game design and gameplay on all level. And, you know, you can go crazy with that. Now we're going to go over the army. This basically says affiliation. So player, NPC, enemy, and defeat. Now, don't use defeat because they just instantly go off the map. They won't participate at all. So that's what I found in my when I was trying to make a fourth faction in the map. And so the commander right here might be, what's a commander? Well, that's related to the commander AI setting. So it says right here, attack if enemy is in range of the commander. And so they'll attack anyone who's in a range of a certain unit. So we can make Kaito the commander and it'll still follow the AI. And so maybe if you want a special AI where like some horses move once the commander's under attack, then you would use that, this setting right here. But usually it's just left alone for the most part. Now, enemy auto leveling. This is going to difficulty design. So when you have auto level, do not grow in class dependent. Let's make this soldier level 10 because they are scrubs. And we're going to put class dependent. So what that means is that it's going to go to a class and underneath the class settings, you're going to see enemy growths. So 80% HP, 50% power, 30% skill, 20 speed, 12 defense, 15 res. So really bad. Alright, stats all around. You know, again, it's FE8. It's not like really something like Thracia. But as you see, this is how you basically make your game design. So let's make this super. Let's just make this soldier broken and have 200 HP growth. So that means it's going to gain 2 guaranteed HP every level. And it gained 10 levels. So it's going to have about 20 extra HP, which is a lot, especially in early game. So just to show you that if that will work in game. And so we're going to go over for our final part of this tutorial is the background music during battle. And then we're going to go over this little space right here. So right here, you're going to see the background music I play. So for example, Neil's is The Battle Must Be Won. So if you want a certain character to have a unique battle theme as a boss, this is where you're going to go. Pretty much self-explanatory, nothing too crazy. How battle quotes work. So battle quotes work in a way that allows a chapter to be completed. So this battle quotes class means that this battle quotes has been activated. If it's just set to 0, then it's going to keep being said over and over and over again. As some, like Danny from FM7, Lord Nurgle has a message waiting for you on the Dread Isle. That's what they do, they just put it to 0. But if you don't want that, just put it to 1. Attacking unit means any, so anyone who's attacking O'Neill will trigger this quote, vice versa, as you see right there, they switch. So if you want like custom battle quotes, and let's make Gilliam or Franz have a custom quote, and then he will, and you'll have to go down the list. And a little word of discretion here, it goes down like by priority by going, starting from here and going all the way to the bottom. So for example, Gebs activates right here. But Amelia has priority. If you put it underneath Gebs and then, you know, you attack someone, Geb, Amelia's won't trigger. So if you have any unique boss conversations, put it on top of the regular generic boss conversations, so that way it can trigger. And even her completion flag is different. It's a temporary flag instead of a battle quotes flag. And so you gotta keep that in mind. But the temporary flag just tells it that don't have Amelia talk to anyone yet. Anyways, so with that said, how does the chapter end with a death quote? The death quote tells the game that, okay, boss is dead. So it triggers a defeat boss flag. Now this defeat boss flag, once it turns on, once, you know, the game realizes, oh no, the boss is dead, it's going to go over to right here. Defeat boss flag condition. So basically, the trigger flag is going to be the defeat boss flag that happens when the death quote triggers. And the completion flag is the cease flag. And the cease flag is a universal chapter end clear. Basically triggers the chapter end event, as you see right here. And so that's how you can set up boss levels. So for example, let's see which one. Where's a route map? They're here. Ancient Horrors. This one's route. But let's say you want a boss on this map. Then you just have to change it to seize boss flags and make sure you give everyone the proper quotes and make sure it works. And so that's how you basically change the objective of a chapter into defeat boss. Let's see. Anything else? Oh yeah. Custom animations. So basically, your custom animations that you're going to find them at is going to be on FEUniverse. It's a giant graphics repository, whole bunch. You can download it. I downloaded mine overnight. It's a bit wonky for me, but it's okay. And there's a Phantom Animations website where you can just directly download them. Shin, the owner of the website, is still trying to update it from what I remember. And so I give it some more time. They're updating the whole thing, updating UI, and putting the new animations like the Dread Fighters in. And so, you know, you can wait for that until that happens. And I think that's all we have for today. Oh, wait. One more thing. When you make a new class, let's say in, like, the monster categories. Let's say you don't want monsters game main, but you want, like, maybe Dread Fighters in place of the Bone Walker. You're going to have to change their footsteps inside the footstep editor. So what you're going to just type in here is just footsteps. Better movement sounds. And then you gotta change it inside the editor. So, for example, I made my Dread Fighter and I replace it with the Bone Walker class. Everything set up, animation, but when they go in the actual game, they start going all wonky on me. Like, you can hear the Bone Walker walking animation. And so, to change that, you gotta find Bone Walker. It would be called Dread Fighter in this case if I actually put in Dread Fighter. Change it from Skeleton Rattle to default walking sound. There's a whole bunch of them, but those are mainly for the flying units and monster units. Yeah. Looks good. Let's go boot up the ROM now so I can show you the actual, like, the animations actually work in the game. But yeah, it was really fun making the ROM hack so far. And I said just for you to try to find yourself some friends who are interested in ROM hacking. But again, once I release this, we're going to also release the Discord link. And so if you want to get some hacking experience, just come over to the Grug Hacking Discord. We got plenty of room. Trust me. So we're going to skip all this. Okay, just skip all this. Boom. So the map animations work, but what's going on? Where's our, we don't have no weapons, first of all. And on top of that, where's the enemies? And so this is what happens sometimes when you mess with a unit placer. Sometimes you can mess with something. And yeah, that's what I did. I changed the turn right here. Yeah. Yeah, okay. I know what I did. I did wrong. So again, it's supposed to be a tutorial branch event. But I didn't. I guess I something messed around with it when I changed like the enemy unit. So what we're going to do is going to go to the eventing screen right here. Go to unit placer. And we're going to put load units and move. Use for new. Because these are new units. They're not loaded from memory. Press them. Double click. Double click right here in the unit placer. Boom. Insert. Boom. They're going to appear on the map now. Awesome, huh? So, yeah. That's how you insert your units. And now, yeah. So now you can see them on the map now. They're going to load. So let's run that ROM again. Little soldier, Yard of America. Boom, Enemy units, let's go. And I forgot to give our protagonist a sword, but Kaito has a sword, so boom. Oh my god, he's OP. Oh, let's check out the unarmed animation works. Man, Kaito's going off. So boom, kill the boss, flag works. But let's go give Kazuya a sword. I'm gonna do it off screen here so I don't have to go through all the setup. Let's run the emulator again. And now it should actually... Hey, it should spawn with a sword. Yeah, and guess what, guys? The animation should work. Animation works, guys. Look right there. Beautiful, beautiful animation. I love this animation. Especially when working with palettes. So, that's the gist of it, I guess. Thank you for tuning in. And this is Memes R, signing off.